Another example is in terms of epilepsy and epilepsy localization. As what we know, 50 million people in the world suffer from epilepsy. About one-third of them actually do not respond well to the drug. Now, among those people who do not respond to drug, the current clinical practice is to find out where that seizure is coming from, and if it is possible, there's one possible way is to resect that seizure-generating tissue to treat the epilepsy. So here is, you can see that because the EEG, as what I mentioned, it has currently has a low spatial resolution, so which is not being used in clinic setting yet. And on the other hand, an fMRI is not fast enough. Of course, not just it's not fast, but also we cannot anticipate when the seizure comes. And if a seizure actually do come, you cannot put a patient into the fMRI scanner. So the clinical routine is really to open their skull and put a grade electrode or some depth electrode to do intracranial recording, and then put a patient back to ICU to under their under video monitoring, and usually is 4 to 10 days. So it's a very long time. When seizure come, and then you try to see, okay, which electrode is generating such kind of seizure. So we have been trying to developing non-invasive imaging technology and to map, say, where the seizure is being generated from non-invasive EEG. This is just one example. Our first effort is to try to image this ECoG or electrocorticogram non-invasively. In this particular case, you can see that this is a scalp EEG response, and at 25 milliseconds after median nerve electrical stimulation, and this is the non-invasive imaging result over the cortical surface, and this is the same patient, went to OR, opened the skull, doctor gave the same median nerve stimulation, and do direct invasive recording. So you can see this invasive recording ECoG patch and with our non-invasive imaging, which show quite a reasonable correspondence between the invasive versus non-invasive and the results. And we have applied this technology to a group of pediatric patients because in pediatric patients, usually the epilepsy in many cases come from neocortex, which the cortical, the ECoG actually is a very good way to localize where the seizure come from. So in this particular case, you can see the interictal spike, and here is our non-invasive imaging result shown by the green blue color, and here is, these are the implanted and invasive electrode, and this shows seizure onset zone identified by this invasive recording, which shows a reasonable correspondence between invasive versus non-invasive results. So we have also tried in adult patient that say if the seizure comes from deep portion, how could we do? And a further challenge in this field is virtually all the technology from either EEG or MEEG. People usually is to map or localize interictal spike because there's a challenge. Number one is very difficult. There wasn't no technology to image the seizure directly, even though you can record it. Number two, in MEEG recording, and this is in principle is very difficult to record the seizure response. So most effort has been in interictal and spike localization. So our group has developed a technology which is allow us to image the seizure directly and using something we call independent component and decomposition, and we get a time course of the independent component, a spatial component of their spatial map of independent component. So we turn like you could be several thousand data points in a single seizure into a limited number of selected independent components and solve just a couple inverse problems and to recombine them.